I caught this on your feed, which I think was really interesting. And I was reading through this article about, and I've noticed this too, and it's almost like it's become kind of trendy right now to this idea of like being estranged from your family. And of course, like as we go along and more folks are, you know, not saying you if you come from like an abusive household that you can't set boundaries with your parents and like ask for better for yourself. But I just feel like since therapy has become more and more kind of common, it seems like it does correlate with this kind of trend of like, oh, I'm cut off from my mom, I'm cut off from my dad. Like, and I think it has become a bit more accepted. Is this necessarily a good thing or a bad thing? I wanted to know like what you thought. You know, not like you should just be like, well, you know, you're obligated to your family and that doesn't mean they can treat you like shit and you'll always be there. But I feel like we should be meeting somewhere in the middle.
Yeah. I mean, this came up a lot when I was writing this teen advice column, which I stopped doing in, I guess it was the end of 2018, maybe. And there was an interesting, I don't know if I want to call it a trend, but, you know, a marked increase in the eagerness of young people to see themselves as, you know, not just, you know, sort of misunderstood, but as so misunderstood that they needed to like cut ties with their parents. And it was one of these things where, you know, frequently the person in question was like 16 or 17 years old and still living at home. And they would, you know, be talking about these conflicts that they had with their parents and how, like, they don't understand me. And, you know, sometimes it was because of, you know, they were, like, gender questioning or gender nonconforming, or sometimes it was a sexuality issue. You know, it was this sort of the start of this very intense focus on identity as it's currently conceived, as it's sort of currently talked about. And, you know, yeah, it was odd how it almost seemed like it was considered sort of a badge of honor in some ways to feel like you were so misunderstood by your family that you were just going to cut them off, you know, or you were just going to cut ties with them. Like you couldn't be asked or expected to try to work things out. You know, it wasn't even worth it to attempt it, you know, that it was fine to just say I'm done, you know. And I always thought that was something I tried to push back against, because I think people, especially when they're young and, you know, they don't know what it's like yet to have an adult relationship with their parents, I don't think that people realize how, you know, intense estrangement actually is.
Yeah.
You know, and how much pain it involves and how, you know, it becomes, you know, a wound that it's not like you just cut ties and you walk away. Like that's a lingering pain. So I think that it's certainly not a decision that should be made lightly.
It is interesting. I wonder if like, I think the way that I see, and I've had disagreements with my family, like my God, like so many, like I had so many blowups with my dad just over and hard times really show you, I think, who your family members are. And I remember I'd have such fights with my dad over like how he was dropping the ball handling my mom's like cancer treatment, and how he just was like, I was noticing like, oh wow, he wants to do it all by himself, even though he is also another man in his 70s and like isn't like, I was so mad. I would yell at him. I'd be like, why are you not hiring like a home aide? And I was like, oh, I was like, that's because he's trying to make up for like maybe not being the best husband like throughout his whole life. And he's thinking like, I need to do this to like make up for it. And it's like, of course, in hindsight, I see what he was doing. But at the time, it was so hard, not only just to like watch my mom like kind of wither away, but we just were fighting so, so much. But the thing is, there were many times I wanted to just like cut off from my dad. I would even like see a therapist about it. And I think I always come back to the idea like the relationships you have with your family is it's like a marriage where it's like there is sort of the obligation to try a little bit harder. Whereas if you were just dating a guy, sure, just break up. Like, oh, he's a fuck boy. Goodbye. It's like, this is your family. And I think it's more helpful to see them as kind of like a marriage and approach it that way than just somebody that you can break up with and turn your back on. I just feel like you owe your blood like a little bit more effort than just sure. like the average person.
I mean, I feel, you know, it's not just that, but also what you owe yourself. There's, you know, this, I don't know. One of the things about growing up is that you do start realizing that your parents are also people, you know, mm-hmm. and that's a hard thing to realize, and it's illuminating. And then there's this, you know, period in which you're, you know, you have sort of both lenses, and it's difficult to negotiate, you know, to understand, like, here is, you know, my mom or my dad, who I saw as this sort of unknowable alien who's just like a grown up, and there was this, you know, obscurity there. And then you start to see them as a human being, and that can be incredibly uncomfortable, you know, to, especially if your parents made mistakes, which, you know, obviously all do, some worse than others. But yeah, to just kind of bail on that before you've really had a chance to reckon with, you know, a more adult approach, not just to your family, but to the world at large, you know, understanding how to relate to other adults as an adult. I think people really deprive themselves, you know, if they bow out of that the moment that it gets uncomfortable.
Yeah, it is like what you said. It's a hard moment when you realize, like, oh yeah, my parents are not just, they're not just this all powerful unknowable being, which is like kind of how you feel about them when you're a kid, and then you're an adult, mm-hmm. you're like, oh, they're like just people too with faults, like doing the best they can with what they have and the awareness they have at that time. And once you factor all that in, you're like, oh, not that you see them like less as a lesser of a person, but you're just, yeah, they're human. And I, to the degree to which you cannot take how your family treats you, I guess, personally. I mean, of course, there's so many examples, like, of course, with real abuse that does feel really personal. But I think the degree to which you can be like, okay, like my parents or my family members are like limited. Think of it as like a limitation or like a disability. Even it's like, well, they just don't know. They're not self-aware. I know that helps me when I like get mad at my dad. I'm just like, he grew up mad at his dad. Like, there's going to be some like kind of backlash. I don't know. I'm rambling. I'm